A local jeepney manufacturer urges the government to maintain the traditional look of Philippine jeepneys. Francisco Motors says while it's necessary to modernize these vehicles, there's a way to upgrade them and keep their classic design at the same time.
Ang sa akin po, ang inilalaban po natin dyan ay bakit natin papalitan ng minibus ang tunay na jeepney. Ang jeepney po ay parte na po ng ating kultura pati kasaysayan na hindi dapat mawala. Pero kailangan nating i-modernize. Hindi po natin maikakailayan. Kailangan po nating i-modernize. Pero hindi natin kailangan palitan ng ibang type na sasakyan. Nick. Ang hari ng kalsada po, ilalaban po natin yan na hindi mawala.
Tama.
Na dapat po ang jeepney natin ay tunay na jeepney at hindi minibus.
Another reprieve for local motorists as oil prices are set to go down for the second week in a row. Kerosene prices will take the biggest cut of up to 1 peso and 90 centavos per liter. A liter of diesel may be up to 1 peso and 40 centavos cheaper, while gasoline will take the smallest drop at up to 1 peso per liter. Analysts attributed the expected decline to the closure of some banks in the U.S. and Switzerland, which lessens demand for oil. Nearly 60 motorists penalized on the first day of the implementation of the exclusive motorcycle lane along Commonwealth Avenue in Quezon City. This includes riders who go beyond the provided lanes for them and public utility vehicles occupying the motorcycle lane. Fines ranging from 500 to 1,200 pesos await violators. The Metro Manila Development Authority appeals to motorists to comply for their own safety.
We appeal to all the motorists since March 9 po up to March 24. Mahigit 20,000 ang aming nasita na mga nagva-violate nito. And hopefully, with that span na ginawa naming dry run, sana naman ngayon respetuhin na nila at sumunod sa aming bagong programa. Ang layunin po nito is for their own safety. Ang prime purpose natin ito is to promote road safety and to promote traffic discipline.
The agency is also looking forward to roll out the program in other major roads in Metro Manila to lessen traffic accidents. The U.S. will extend more assistance to the Philippines to help fast-track oil spill containment efforts in Oriental Mindoro. Acting Defense Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. says members of the U.S. Coast Guard and their air assets are set to arrive in the country. A U.S. aircraft with equipment already arrived Sunday. Meanwhile, responders say nearly 17 kilometers of the shoreline of Pola, Oriental Mindoro have yet to be cleared.
Nabawasan na siya from the previous na more than 30. So, it's a good indication that, of course, yung aming effort ay effective. We will now go to the phase 2, which is yung mga dumikit sa bato. We apply pressure washing like that. And
the full recovery of the Philippine tourism industry seen next year. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco says things are looking up at the start of 2023 with arrivals hitting 1.3 million with a few more days still left in the first quarter. Frasco says that figure is about half of the total arrivals last year, which stood at 2.65 million.
Last year, our numbers would show that we were a little over 30% recovery, but we foresee that this year we will be recovering up to 4.8 million international visitors and 100% recovery for domestic tourism. And we foresee that next year we will recover 100% as far as our 2019 numbers are concerned. Kaya lang nakikita natin na hindi na yun yung goal natin 2019. Yung goal natin is to exceed these numbers kasi napakaganda po ng Pilipinas. We have the best islands,
yes.
And we have the best people.